In this lesson, I'm going to talk about how you can use the brackets preferences file to update your preferences on a user level or by project. Many preferences can be set through the user interface and menus, but some things like JS Lint options will need to be set by editing the file. If you go to the debug menu, you can find Open Preferences File. It's opened a file called brackets.json. It's showing my current user preferences. If I change any of the preferences, they're immediately reflected in this file. If I increase the font size, it's shown right here. If I turn word wrap off, it's reflected on that preference. If I turn line numbers off through the menu, it adds a new preference setting down at the bottom. That preference was not in here already, so it was added. For some preferences, I can change the value through the menu or by editing the file. I can change line numbers back to true right here, or I could delete the line entirely and it would default to true. In the last lesson, I talked about the JS linting that's happening on my files, and I mentioned that some of the errors it gives I don't want to see. You can look at the jslint.com website to see the reference and the options that are available to you. The two options I want are at the bottom. I want to set vars and white to true. To be honest, I don't like turning white to true since that allows other white space issues to be ignored that I do want to catch. I solved this problem by linting my code outside of brackets later with JS Hint, which allows more fine-grained control of some of these options. There's also a JS Hint extension that can be used with brackets, but I'm sticking to JS Lint for now. Notice how many errors I have in the JavaScript file right now. If I go back to the preferences and set up some jslint.options, I'll add vars true and white true, and then save it. When I go back to the file, those errors are gone. The only one that remains is this jQuery error. If we scroll up on the options, you can see there's a predef option which allows you to describe strings as globals in your code. It accepts an array of strings, so I need to use square brackets here. Case does matter, so I need to type jQuery correctly. If I save that and go back to my file, I have no more errors and I see a green checkbox saying it linted fine. Of course, you'll need to decide for your own projects what linting preferences you want to use. If you're not strong in JavaScript, I recommend researching each error you encounter and read different opinions so you can make an educated decision. There are often smart people who disagree on these things. I have learned a lot about JavaScript from doing this myself. Now, some of these linting options are going to really be project specific. And you might have some other options that are project specific as well, such as tab versus spaces and how many. If you work on open source projects, you need to follow their style rules. So sometimes you might want something different than your normal setup. Brackets does have a way to specify preferences by project, which is very handy. I'm going to go to a different project and set up unique preferences. The way you do this is by creating a file called .brackets.json. You need the period at the beginning of the file name. I'm going to open the user preferences through the menu first. Then I'll copy those contents. I'll create a new file, paste in the preferences, and save. You need to make sure that you save the file in the top directory of the project. I don't really want to set all of these in my specific project file. I'll keep most of them global, so I can erase those lines here. I'll leave space units, file filters, and jslint.options, since these are all things that would be project specific. First, I'll change the space units to 4. See how it changed right down here when I saved? If I go to a different project now, my spaces are set to 2 because that's my user option. But back on my public project, it's back to 4. I am going to delete this line because I do actually want to keep 2 spaces in this project. I'm not going to change the file filters, but this is definitely something that could be changed per project since folder structures will be different. This is referencing the exclude file filters that we set up in a previous lesson. If I open the app.js file, we can see some linting errors. Some I might want to fix, but I'm going to focus on these last 2 errors. Since it's a backbone and marionette project and they are available to me globally, I can add them to my pre-def list. Now when I look at the errors, those last two are gone. Any options I set up in this project preferences file will override what's set in the global user brackets.json file. I'll add a link in the lesson notes to some documentation on the brackets preference system so you can see the preferences available to you if you want to explore further. In the next lesson, I'm going to talk about overriding the brackets keyboard shortcuts.